So, and a ranking for britishboxers.co.uk. Okay, coming into the pro ranks from a white collar background, did you ever believe you were going to win a world title, or has your career exceeded your expectations?
To be honest, when I started professionally boxing, it was just to see how far I could go. I had no aspirations to be a world champion. I just wanted to see really what I could learn, how I could implement it, and to see really where I could get to. And I've outstayed my expectations. I'm a 2-time world champion, and I've got more to give to this sport. So it's a really exciting time for me and an amazing journey.
Okay, you obviously had some very high points in your career, but you had some major setbacks along the way as well. Was there ever a moment where you thought, you know, I did even more than I expected, I can pack it in with my head held high, or what is it that kept you going through all of it?
I'm not that kind of person. It's not in my nature to give up on anything that I set out to do. And I feel like you can only win or you learn from situations, and especially in sport, you know. There's always going to be a winner and a loser. And, you know, as long as you gave the best of yourself on that performance on that night, and then you lost to a better person on the night, then you can go away, take in what you learn, and make yourself better the next time, come out and be a better fighter.
Arguably, you've been to the best in around your weight class in Sanna Marcel and Clarissa Shields. Mm-hmm. Do you think that the lack of a high-profile amateur pedigree like they brought to the table was a factor in you losing those fights?
No, I stepped up to middleweight for those fights. I'm not a middleweight fighter. And of course, I feel that was definitely that played a part in it, of course. But secondly, yes, I don't have a massive amateur pedigree career. Like you said, I came from white collar. I'm not an Olympic style boxer. I just got a different style. And that's just, it's the Hannah style, you know. So I'm proud to be myself. And I think as well that, you know, there's different levels to these things. And I went in to fight them at middleweight, and I'm not a middleweight.
Okay, Natasha Jonas has manifested interest in a new unification bout. Is that something you would consider after this?
Obviously, yes. There's some great fights in Super Welterweight. We have a very exciting division right now. Like, Natasha Jonas has just won the WBO. She stepped up, and no one expected her to come to the Super Welterweight division. Then we've got Marie-Yves Duquer, who's the IBF champion. You've got Patricia Vergault, who's got the WBC. And even Cecilia Brackhouse is now coming to 154. So there's some really exciting fights. Unification with Natasha Jonas would be amazing. Being a UK fight, two UK fighters both holding belts in the same weight division. So that would be exciting and fantastic for British boxing.
Do you have a long-term plan, or do you just taking one fight at a time? When do you think will be the moment for you to call it a day?
Oh, I never put an end on anything like this. You know, you never know how far you're going to go. And as soon as you put a date on something, then you're subconsciously working towards that. So as long as I'm fit and healthy and developing as a fighter, which I always sort of show improvements in the ring, then I'm very happy to go as long as I can go.
Would you consider moving and changing weight class again at one point? Let's say you achieve all your objectives at 154 pounds. Do you think you would move up or down again? Or?
Well, to be a two-weight world champion is any boxer's dream. You know, I would love the opportunity to go down and fight a welterweight. There's a possibility for me as well. I wouldn't be going back up to middleweight, but I would drop down to welterweight for sure.
Okay, last question. Let's not forget you're a bassoonist as well,
yes,
before you're a boxer. So how do music and box complement each other? Is there anything from your music training that is a tool that you use in boxing as well, that is useful in boxing as well?
Absolutely.
And vice versa?
Absolutely. For me, they have a lot in common, really. It's all about performing. Just one is on stage and one is in the boxing ring. So, you know, it's the same sort of adrenaline high for performing in front of a big crowd. There's a lot of dedication, discipline and practice, and both of those things appeal to me. You know, you can't learn everything in both boxing and music, so it always inspires me to work hard in both. So for me, they make a lot of sense and they work really well together.
Would you ever consider playing the bassoon in the ring after a fight?
No, I wouldn't.
You know, Tyson Fury sings, you might as well.
I'm not getting the bassoon out, no. I think I'd be, you know, 10 rounds of wars enough, and then some bassoon, yeah. It's just a bit much.
There might be a new Guinness to your list, no? First,
yeah.
Scottish women to win the world title.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much for your time and all the best.
No problem, thank you.
Bye-bye.